What's up, everyone? This is Hemorrhoid, aka Deep Fryer, bringing you another Super String video. How are you guys doing today? I hope you're doing fantastic. Now, today we're going to have a bit of a laid-back video, because if you read the title of the video, you know what we're going to be doing today, or tonight for me, because it's nighttime as usual. But anyway, we're going to be doing one of my favorite game modes, Event PvP, which means we're going to have some very fun and very unpredictable battles. Now, just to kind of catch up on what I've been up to lately, last week I did have a bit of an impulsive moment where I decided to dump a bunch of nanos on Red Swarm. So, over the course of the last week, I have ended up maxing Red Swarm's skills and working very hard on her gear. And so it turns out that Red Swarm is now one of my top tier agents. I have two different gear sets for her. I have a very, very speedy gear set for countering one Hyo in PvP, countering that confusion that the Dragon Staff applies to the fastest unit on the enemy team. And I also have an attack set for Red Swarm also when I am using her to counter debuffs in general and not specifically one Hyo. Also, a little bit earlier, the Discord, the unofficial Super String Discord channel was talking about cats without my permission. So, if you see my shirt, I've had a few cats in my day. And I succinctly told them they are not allowed to talk about cats unless I'm present. So there'll be a link down in the description below for the unofficial Super String Discord. We have a lot of fun there. There are a lot of really cool, really nice, and really smart people there who can help you with some of your Super String strategies and kind of bring you up to speed on what's going on in the world of the Super String mobile game. Now, let's jump in and let's have a bit of fun with Event PvP. You'll find that under the Challenge menu. It is day 2 in this Event PvP season, and it looks like we need to win 3 times to get ourselves 15 yellow experience cans. And we will always take experience cans all day long. My current project is Hey Myong. I am wanting to build him to do some serious damage to co-op bosses and Abyss. I'd like to use him a bit in Abyss. So I'm hoping to bring him up to level 70. And also, the anniversary event for Super String that's coming up this month in May, is they're going to be introducing selection boxes. Selection boxes for agents and selection boxes for EX weapons. So you'll be able to choose what agent and what EX weapon you want if you're fortunate enough to get your hands on some of these selection boxes, whether that be for free through some event, or maybe you're one of the ones who supports the developers and forks over a little bit of moolah. Now, I've run myself out of time, so I'm going to take Kang Suho. I like to be able to lock down enemy DPS, and they won't be expecting it, because this is Event PvP, and they don't know what units I'm bringing. I'm going to bring Jin Suho for the damage received debuff on his ultimate. Now, this is... I don't really care for either any one of these three picks, but since I have a tank and a debuffer, or a specialist rather, I'm going to take Marlene. She does have the pierce damage, so, you know, I mean, we can do some DPS with her at least. Now, I don't have any bombs or damage over time, so Bangja is tempting. Yeah, I'm going to take Bangja for the Royal Guard was an interesting pick, and maybe I should have taken him, but I'm going to take Bangja because I always like to bring some bombs to Event PvP when I can. Especially when one of those, you know, really, really good bomb units are available to me, because a lot of times the enemy doesn't have an answer for bombs, because, you know, you can't really pick and choose your team with event PvP. You have to kind of, you know, go with what is given to you. So let's jump in here. Let's see who the enemy has brought. Okay, Agite. Let's see. Looks like it's Agite's ring. So Agite is going to resurrect after we bring him to 0 hit points. I'm going to lock down the enemy DPS as usual. And I'm going to apply bombs, AoE bombs with Banja, in this first turn here. Now, the enemy Banja is going to go now. They're probably going to do the same. They're probably going to lay down the bombs on our team, and that's okay. We don't really have a cleanser, but they don't either. So let's just see where the road takes us. Okay, Kim Han has laid just a little bit of damage on our Kang Suho. Not a whole lot. Now here's my thinking. Mito, the enemy has Mito, and Mito can be quite annoying because Mito has that two-turn AoE freeze. So I am going to lay down some damage received on Mito and hopefully the other targets as well. Okay, we only got the damage received on Mito. That's fine. That's all I needed. Because now, Marlene is going to use her ultimate on Mito, and we say, to Mito. So we've already taken down one unit on the enemy team. Okay. Kang Suho. Alright. Let's put another bomb on the enemy Banja. We would like to get rid of Banja as quickly as possible. Now, let's see what the enemy Banja does on their second turn. Okay, here comes the AoE bombs from the enemy. And the enemy Banja is already stunned. Kim Han is trying to do some more damage to Kang Suho. Now, let's actually stun Agite, because if we save our stun for later, when Agite resurrects, Agite cleanses debuffs. So that's not going to help us when we're bringing Agite down to 0 hit points. So we're going to go ahead and use the stun to try to prevent any additional damage. Now, we've taken out the enemy Banja, and I know that I still have two more turns of PvP with Kang Suho. So I'm going to do one more regular attack to Kim Han, and we are going to make sure that we can end Kim Han next turn. Let's throw a little bit of a heal on Kim Suho. And now let's see what the enemy Kim Han does. Gotta think about it, apparently. I think they know that they're about to die, so they're not going to take any more hit points off of Kang Suho. That's actually probably a smart move. Okay, let's do just a little bit more damage to Agite. And yeah, I tell you what we're going to do. We are going to go ahead and resurrect Agite. The reason I'm doing that before Kang Suho's PvP is over is because I don't want Agite's AoE attack to be able to hit Kang Suho. So I'm going to go ahead and resurrect Agite. I could have waited until Kim Han was completely dead to resurrect Agite, but I wanted to go ahead and do that so the AoE attack, so that Kang Suho was still in PvP mode and the AoE attack could not hurt him. I believe that was the best move. Now, we're going to take Kim Han out of the picture. Kang Suho gives himself the defense buff. Do a little bit more damage with Marlene. And basically, it looks like we've got this one in the bag. The enemy is biding their time at this point. So anyway, since this is one of those laid-back event PvP nights, gonna have a little bit of orange drink, so, you know, cheers. And let's see if we can get our first win under our belt. There we have it. There is win number one. And Marlene takes the MVP. We need two more wins to get our rewards on this day two of Event PvP. I hope you guys are having fun with Event PvP just as I am. Now, let's go ahead and see if we can get an opponent for our second match. Looks like we've already got one. What Soquan is this? It looks like this is the Retaliation Soquan, which is the Ignition Bat EX Soquan. So we're going to take him. Cuckoo or Jin Suho are both tempting. And I'm sorry to make you guys watch the same agent twice, but I want Jin Suho for that damage received debuff. Now, okay, this is tough because if I take Kim Bong Chun, which I am incredibly fond of Kim Bong Chun, if I take him, I've got two specialists. But at this point, I don't really care because of the amount of DPS that Kim Bong Chun puts out. Now, out of these, it is tempting to take Wu because of the defense down debuff. But Meyer has Oblivion, so just in case the enemy has one of those agents that really desperately needs to be Oblivioned to give us that edge, even though it means I'm bringing three specialists this round, I went ahead and took Meyer. Now, if the enemy has a lot of attack units and we've brought three specialist units, that puts us at a severe disadvantage, so I can only hope that I can lock them down with some crowd control to give myself the edge. But let's just see what the enemy has brought. Okay. This should be fun. The enemy has brought two attack units in Min Jung Woo and Wan Soon. Soquan is going first. So let's go ahead and open with skill 4, which is going to be our AoE taunt. It's going to put taunt on the enemy for two turns, and it looks like Oh Sejong resisted that taunt, which is very unfortunate because Oh Sejong, okay, well, Oh Sejong ended up attacking Soquan anyway. That's fine. Now, I want to Oblivion. Who do I want to Oblivion? I guess I'm going to Oblivion Min Jung Woo so that we don't run into that Violet state. I don't want to face Violet Min Jung Woo. Alright. Now, maybe I should have Oblivioned Wan Soon, and you could definitely make a case for that. But I just didn't want to face Violet Min Jung Woo right now, just to be honest with you. So I decided to go with him. Now, we have taken out Min Jung Woo. Wan Soon got stunned. Now, Oh Sejong is stunning Soquan again. We're going to throw some damage over time on the enemy. Try to get some hit points taken away from their remaining three units. And Kyra is going to put some bombs on us, but that's okay. We're going to pull out the drone. It is time to let Kim Bong Chun do some DPS to the enemy team. Let's do some DPS to Kyra. She shouldn't last too much longer with her health the way it is right now. Okay, the enemy has killed our Soquan, so that's a little concerning. That is a little bit concerning, but let's see. We're going to go ahead and take out Kyra. We're going to use our ultimate just to make sure she goes down. Now, I actually want to freeze Wan Soon. That is going to be the best move right now since Wan Soon is about to go next. I'm also going to stun Oh Sejong. So that way, we basically skip the enemy's turn this turn, but it looks like a couple of my units are also stunned. So, I think that was the best move. Now, we have taken out the enemy Oh Sejong. And now, let us see what Wan Soon can do versus three of our units. Now, Wan Soon has reset his cooldowns because his passive was propped, and he's resurrected now. So, he will kill one of our units here, at least one. Possibly two at the most. So, but I think we're going to have the edge because Wansul will be at one hit point after he takes his two turns here, and we have three units left. So, I believe we are still going to have the edge, and I'm actually about to put some damage over time on Wansul as well, which is going to help. And, I mean, at this point, it's a numbers game. I have two units left, they have one turn to take, and then they're going to die. So there you have it. There's win number two. So there we go. One more win to get our rewards for day two of event PvP. All right. Our second win calls for another dank. Fortunately, it's not been taking long to get ourselves some opponents, and here we go. Looks like we're facing a very interestingly named opponent. Let's see which van this is. This is Inferno Van. Red Swan is tempting. Gosh, I don't know. I'm going to take Shin Hayul, actually. Let's get us a good healer. I'll take Leonard Shin for the buff block, and he's got a stun also, which is handy in event. Oh, gosh. Here we go again. I guess I'm going to take double specialists because I really want that Oblivion from Maya Wall. Okay, so we're not going to have an attack unit. That's very unfortunate, but Eddie or Lee, which tank do we want? I'm going to take Lee because Lee has the AoE taunt. Lee's ultimate will taunt three people, and Lee also resurrects. Oh, I'm sorry, Lee does not actually resurrect. If you kill Lee without bringing him below his hit points threshold, he will not regenerate. But if you bring Lee below a certain threshold of hit points, and I don't remember exactly what the percentage is because this is event PvP, so Lee's skills are maxed. But I want to think a skill level 1 Lee was around maybe, if he drops below, maybe 35% hit points or 40, 30, 40, somewhere around in there. He will regenerate some of his hit points. Let's go ahead and open with... Let's open with the AoE taunt. Now, unfortunately, the enemy team has three very strong AoE DPS, Kawuka, Ms. Huang, and Elamona. So the enemy basically has the three strongest the three strongest AoE DPS in the game. So I'm actually not very confident in this match. If I were a betting man, I would bet that we're going to lose this. We don't give up here, but I don't have a good feeling when I have brought, you know, two specialists and the enemy has three of the best AoE DPS units in the game. It doesn't give me a great feeling, okay? But let's just see what happens here. The enemy's Ms. Huang is about to go. Now Ms. Huang, I'm gonna go ahead and stun Ms. Huang, because I don't want her putting bombs on us right now, even though Aikawa is about to do it anyway, but let's see here. We're actually going to confuse Aikawa with Maya Wall. That's one of the reasons I love this unit. She's very versatile. She has Oblivion, Confuse, can steal enemy buffs. Let's see here. Let's see if we can taunt Elamona again. We've applied an additional taunt. I want to try to keep Maya Wall in the game, so let's see if we can put some invincibility. Yes, we put some invulnerability on Maya Wall. Let's see what happens. Kawuka is probably, Kawuka's actually taunted, so Kawuka has to attack Lee. Or, okay, Kawuka is going to shield. Looks like Ms. Huang, and that's a good move because Ms. Huang is probably going to try to apply some bombs to us on her next turn and then try to detonate them on the following turn. Alright, we're going to bring out Leonard Chen's debuff attack, which is going to apply decreased turn, buff block, and poison. So let's try to get some more damage going on the enemy. Let's see. We've got all in. That does extra damage per buff I have. Yeah, I guess. We're about to die anyway, so let's try to do some damage to Aikawa, I suppose. Okay, folks, this is not looking good at all. I don't know about this one, guys. I just don't know about this one. We may have to do one more fight after this one. I don't really think we've made any, you know, major mistakes per se, but, you know, sometimes the RNG with selecting these teams is just not in our favor. That's just part of it. That's the name of the game. And it looks like the enemy is going to try to take out Shin Hayul now so that she cannot resurrect people. That's what they're going to do, and we're going to chop this one up as a loss. That's fine. We're going to come back next match, and we're going to get our third win. I hope you guys are ready, because I'm ready. I'm having a ton of fun. Let's see what happens. Alright, there we go. There's our first loss of the evening. Not a problem. We still have more wins than losses. So, you know, having a positive ratio is always the way to go. That's what we like to see. So let's go ahead and try to get our next match. There is 1 hour until the game maintenance is initiated. Looks like we're going up against someone from Korea Named, which is the number one alliance in the game. That's all right, because everyone is on equal footing in event PvP. We're going to go with Juan Hayo for that confusion. I think I want Mamiya for the Savage Damage and the Cleanse. I want Cha Yaren for the Cleanse and the Retaliate. And what else do I want? I guess I want Bangja to throw some bomb. No, I want Uchida for the Freeze and the Defense Down. Alright, let's see what happens. I really wish I had a tank, but unfortunately, I was not able to pull a tank from the selection process. So let's just jump into this match and see what happens. I'm not feeling really great about my team right now, but you know, we do the best with what we have to work with. They've got Eddie, Kawuka, oh boy, yeah, this is gonna be fun. All right, let's see what we've got here. At least Dokeman was confused, so he couldn't put that guard on anyone, but now Eddie is gonna come out with his AoE taunt. Okay. And now Katarina is going to put that damage reflective increased turn meter on the enemy team, which means Kawuka is going to go next. So basically the entire enemy team has taken their turn before me. So we are starting this match at a very great disadvantage. So let's see if we can turn the tide. You know, sometimes you can, but then again, sometimes you can't. Let's see here. You know what, guys? This is already not looking good at all. Let's just pull out the Savage Damage on Eddie. We may kill ourselves with that Damage Reflect, but, you know, and we did. We killed ourselves with the Damage Reflect. I was prepared for that. That's fine. There's not too many other debuffs the enemy can do, so I'm just going to go ahead and do this cleanse, this AoE heal cleanse that Cha Yaren has, just to kind of give us a chance to get back in this match a little bit. Let's bring out Juan Hayo's ultimate, try to get some damage done to the enemy, and let's see if we can freeze the enemy. A full proc would be great here. We got 3 out of 4, you know, so we'll take it. Let's see here. Let's do a what are we going to do? Let's actually attack Katarina with a regular attack. And we're going to put a heal. We're going to put a heal on Juan Hayo. Try to keep our team alive as long as we can here. I don't want to use my AoE attack because I don't want to wake Kawuka up just yet. But I also don't want to inflict pain on myself from the damage reflect, so we're going to go for Katarina. Let's see here. I'm going to go ahead and pull out the ultimate on Katarina just because I would like to kind of tip the numbers back in our favor a little bit and at least take out an enemy unit. So we have taken out enemy unit now, but now, you know, of course, they're going to take out one of my units, and that's fine. I expected that. Now, at least Eddie's damage reflect is gone. So let's see if we can get rid of Eddie. I think we can. Okay, Eddie is down. Okay, Dokeman is going to do his move where he gives himself effect resist and hit points. But now we are going to start targeting Kawuka because we don't want Kawuka in this match any longer than Kawuka has to be in this match, because Kawuka is going to be the main source of damage against our team right now. I'm not terribly worried about Dokeman. Now, Kawuka is, of course, going to shield the enemy team. Dokeman is going to use... Okay, now that was actually probably a bit of a mistake on the enemy's part, in my humble opinion, because Kawuka just put two turns of shield on Kawuka. So Dokeman's two turns of guard, you know, really has no effect on Kawuka whatsoever, because Kawuka is already shielded. So I'm just going to go ahead and dispel Dokeman's buffs, try to do a little bit of damage to Dokeman while Kawuka is shielded, and I can't really do anything to Kawuka. I am really hoping Kawuka's ultimate AoE attack does not come off of cooldown. That would not be fun for me right now, because we are starting to look like we might be able to pull us a win out of this yet. Even though the beginning of the match looked very much like we were not going to be able to pull this one out, but as you can see, the tide can quickly turn in these event PvP matches. Alright, now I don't want to wake up Dokeman yet if I don't have to. But at the same time, I don't want to use... Well, Chaoyaren's about dead, so I'm going to go ahead and use the heal just to bring Wanhyo up to speed with the health. Now, let's go ahead and use our ultimate again on Wanhyo. I'm really thinking that Kawuka's ultimate is probably merely off of cooldown. We had a double miss. Okay, double miss. It happens. I really want Kawuka dead. That is my number one priority, because Kawuka poses us the greatest threat right now. So we have got to take out Kawuka. That is a must. And I believe I'm going to be able to take out Kawuka this next turn, unless Uchida is taunted. And Uchida is taunted now. But Uchida has the ultimate available as well. So we've done some more damage to Dokeman. Kawuka is going to do some devastating damage to us via the Morningstar passive. Dokeman is probably going to try to take out Uchida in this move right here. And might do it. No, Dokeman is actually taunting Wanhyo, but that may have been a bad move, because Wanhyo has countered and killed Dokeman, and Wanhyo was able to deliver the finishing blow to Kawuka. And what do you know? Chaoyaren, you know... Schoolgirl herself has brought the MVP for our team, and that brings us to our three wins in this day two of event PvP. So the new game update is about to happen in about an hour. I believe they're going to be introducing some of the 1 year anniversary festas a little bit early, just to give us some additional time to celebrate the game's 1 year anniversary that's coming up later this month. So I hope you guys have a lot of fun with that, but the game will be down for a few hours, which by the time you watch this video, it'll be the next day or beyond. So that won't even matter for you guys anyway. But I think I have something here for you guys to give you a little bit of entertainment at the end. Let's see, I'm going to pull the SS Agent ticket for you guys. I am going to save the SSEX core for our next video. Sorry, I know you want to see that, but hey, that means you're going to have to watch my next video. So like and subscribe if you want to see more SuperString content and you want to see what SSEX core I get in the next video. But for now, let's see what SS agent I pull. Let's hope it's not one that I cannot get an awakening for. Who's it gonna be? Wonderful, 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 Tina, 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 all day, all night, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, all day long, we will take our first awakening for Tina. And the reason that I'm so excited about seeing just one awakening for Tina, you're about to see it right here. It is because the Glinda module Awakening Universe is now active, which means I have just activated 2.86% additional speed on all of my units, which is going to give me a little bit more of an edge in basically every game mode, because speed is important wherever you go, especially for PvP. But anyway, there you have it, folks. There is event PvP. Lots and lots of fun for you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. And, I guess that's it. So, everybody have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you soon. Until next time, this is Hemroid.
What's wrong, Annie?
I maxed Brillhart's skills. I maxed them all. They're maxed. Every single one of them. And not just her skills, but her EX weapon. And her auxiliary core too. I'm like a dummy. And I maxed her like a dummy. I hate myself.
でっかい